Hello and welcome back for our history lesson number 3 in the earliest cities, the session 3. So today we are going to learn more about the village life of the people in the Harappan civilization, and we'll just have a closer look on two of the important Harappan towns in Gujarat. One is Dholavira and the other is Lothal. So here we go. In the previous session, we have discussed about the life in city, where we saw people busy with different kinds of activities, and it was a busy life. So here in the villages, the important occupation or the only occupation was agriculture. And generally the farmers stayed in the countryside or the outskirts of the cities. And what was the important work of these farmers? Yes, to grow and supply food to the rulers, the scribes and the craftspeople, or we can just say the people who resided in the cities. So these people importantly grew wheat, barley, pulses, peas, rice, sesam, linseed and mustard. So these are the different varieties which were grown on a large scale by the Harappan peasants or the farmers. And even in those times, the plow was invented to till the soil and to sow the seeds. So earlier to this, or prior, when the plow was not there, not available, people used different kinds of stones to dig the soil and to sow the seeds. We have learned this in the earlier chapters. And most importantly, these people also knew the technique of storing water, which could be used as irrigation system in times of scarcity. So for example, we have studied that each and every house had an well for the water supply. So similarly, they also constructed different kinds of wells in the areas where water was required during the times of no rains. And people also reared sheep, goat, buffaloes. They gathered fruits like berries, and also they practiced fishing and hunting animals such as antelopes. So we can surely say that the ancient occupations of hunting and gathering or herding of animals kept on going even though men learned agriculture. So here in the village of Harappa or the Harappan villages, they practiced agriculture as an important occupation, and along with that they also reared animals. They gathered certain kinds of fruits and roots, and also practiced fishing as well as hunting of wild animals like the antelope. I hope this point of village life, or specifically about the occupations, is clear to each and every one of you. So now let's focus more on the Harappan town in Gujarat, which is Dholavira. Now here you can also see I have already highlighted that part, but still we will check once. See, can you see this part? Yes, here this is the part called Dholavira, and this town in Gujarat is located in Rann of Kutch. I hope most of you have heard about the Rann of Kutch. Now let's see the exact location of Rann of Kutch, and so you can locate Dholavira also there. So here, can you see, this is the area of Rann of Kutch, and then when we were looking at the previous map, we found that Dholavira is situated here. So it's in Rann of Kutch, right? So now exact location is given here. So it is located on the Khadir Bet. So what is a bet? A kind of an island or a small area in Rann of Kutch. Okay, now Rann of Kutch, we know it's like with a dry area, but this part of Khadir Bet had a fertile land and also a good supply of fresh water, and so this city was situated over there. It was divided into three parts. Now what were the three parts that the city was divided into? It was like each part was surrounded by huge stone walls and had large open areas for public ceremonies. So a huge walls were constructed to divide the city or the town into different parts. And how was the construction of walls done? They were built up using huge stones with the interlocking method, or sometimes tar was used for the cementing purposes. Now here there are different kinds of Harappan scripts which are found on these walls, or they are carved out of white stones, or maybe sometimes on wood as well. This is a unique find, as generally Harappan writings has been found on smaller objects such as seals. So now earlier when we discussed about seals and sealings, there we found that this Harappan script was very small script, but here it is a unique findings that these Harappan letters are carved or engraved on huge pieces of stones or carved on huge pieces of woods. So this is an important part here in the Harappan civilization. But yet, as we discussed, that this script is not yet deciphered, and so we cannot make out what is exactly written or what those symbols mean to us. We are not able to relate the meaning with the symbols. Now let's move with the next Harappan town in Gujarat. Again an important place. And what is that place? The name of which is Lothal. Now you can say Lothal is also situated in Gujarat, towards south of Dholavira. Now where is exactly Lothal situated? Lothal is situated on the banks of river Sabarmati. Can you see? I have even marked it here. So an important river of Gujarat. So now why was this place very important? Now here, many of the raw materials such as semi-precious stones were easily available. And this was also an important center where different kinds of things or objects were made using stones, shells and metals. It also says that there were storehouses in this city, because many seals and sealings, like impressions of different kinds of pictures and symbols, have been excavated from here, which was done on clay. And then it was also an important place from the point of view of transport. So a huge dockyard or a huge tank which had a dockyard was present in Lothal, where generally boats and ships came from the sea through this river channel, and goods were probably loaded and unloaded over there. So Lothal is an important city as well as a dockyard for those people who stayed during the Indus Valley civilization. And generally these storehouses, what we say, also had bead making workshop, and which was found after excavation, and certain kinds of pieces of stones, half made beads, different tools for bead making, and even finished beads were found or excavated from this place. And so we can say it was an important workshop, maybe for jewelry or ornament making as well. Next, the important part, we discussed what is a seal in the earlier session. Now here, these seals, what is the use of these seals? So these seals may have been used to stamp bags or packets containing goods which were sent from place to place. So as I discussed earlier, it was one of the stamp or impression which was used when you pack a thing and we need to send it to someone. Now after a bag was closed or tied, a layer of wet clay was applied on the knot and the seal was pressed on it. The impression of the seal is known as sealing. If the sealing was intact, one could be sure that the goods have arrived safely. Now, even in these days when we order something online, if the packing is broken, we say that it is not arrived safely to us. Maybe in between, someone must have opened it. Same was the belief in those days. If the seal was intact, it was properly maintained, the good was arrived safely, or else someone had opened it earlier. So more than 2000 such seals have been found at various sites in this civilization. They were generally small, flat, rectangular or square in shape and made of clay, soapstone or copper. They were often carved with figures of humans and animals like an unicorn, humped bull, goat, tiger or elephant and certain other symbols which were engraved on it. So today we have discussed about the life in a village, where we studied about the occupations that people followed. Then we had discussion about the towns of Gujarat, one of which is Dholavira, situated on the Khadir Bet in the run of Kutch, and the next is Luthal, which is an important dockyard situated beside the tributary of Sabarmati River in Gujarat. And we also said that it was an important center for workshops, as we found certain remains of beads and other objects which were made from stones, shells or metals. And finally, we discussed the importance of seals even in those days, and the impression which a seal gives was known as sealings. So this is all from my side about this topic for today. I hope every point is clear. If not, do make a note and ask me when we meet for our sessions. So till then, take care. Bye-bye. Stay healthy. Stay safe.